So, Jorge Garcia, that name mean anything to you?
No, I don't. I have never met the man.
All right. He is a man in Detroit, Michigan. He was just deported. He was brought here when he was 10 years old. He's lived here almost 30 years. Didn't make the Dreamer cutoff, though. He literally missed it by a year. He was deported because of what's going on right now with immigration enforcement, and his family is still here. His wife, who was born here, is a citizen. His two kids, citizens, born here. And they are being seen as an example of what you must fix. What is the chance that you fix the situation for someone like the Garcias? Tax-paying, good, no criminal record, family, community. Are you going to fix it?
Yeah, we should, Chris. And I've been saying that from day one. We got to get back to what it takes to be a legal immigrant in this country. That's what people want. They want to embrace legal immigration. You know, we got to get past this aspect that the government is responsible when laws are broken. You know, I think Ronald Reagan said it best. We have to have that accountability. So Jorge knew about the situation looming over this aspect. And where's the personal accountability?
He was 10.
There are a bunch of sad stories. But
he was 10.
From that standpoint, we want to make sure. Well, we want to make sure we go back to the rule of law. You know, his parents, you know, were the lawbreakers.
Yeah, they broke the law. They came in illegally.
But absolutely.
But you know what, Congressman? Here's what I want to test on that. There are laws, and then there is law enforcement, okay? There is a subjective component to laws that are on the books, how they're enforced, and when they're enforced. Would you agree with that?
To a certain degree, yeah.
So you have a situation where you cannot come into the country the way he did. Understood. But he's a child, so personal accountability has to go out the window. At the age of 10, you can't even form criminal intent, let alone be held accountable for being brought in here.
And then Chris, it comes back to being a part of that family. And you want to keep the family together, but the lawbreakers were the parents.
Right.
And so you've got to make that break there.
But what is your priority? You know, I understand terrorists, drug dealers, people who commit felonies. I understand the exigency, the harm, the potential for harm with that population and why you want to seize on legal enforcement. I get it. How does Garcia fit into your need of protection?
Well, in the case, if we were talking about the gentleman that was on the show earlier, you know, the comment from his wife was, is they want an individual basis. And the only way that you can look on an individual basis is by going through the legal process the proper way. That's the key here is if you want to have the blessings of this country, do it right. I mean, from that standpoint, they said do it one by one, not in mass. And I've said that from day one. Let's give some certainty, but let's go back to what it takes to be a legal person coming to this country legally and break it down in front of the American people so that they actually intercede and give their viewpoints, whether it be enforcement of sovereign law, whether it be chain migration, whether it be a border wall. All those applications have to be done in front of the American people.
What does that mean, done in front of the American people?
Share with them, because, I mean, they're the government, Chris. They're the ones that, you know, when you had Youngstown on, these are the people that are tired of the way the country is going, where we're facilitating lawbreakers instead of upholding those people that follow the law. That's what made us great, Chris.
The American people are as close to unanimous on anything I've seen them on about wanting to protect the Dreamers and people like the Garcias.
See, I got to tell
you. Your own party is at 75% in the Quinnipiac poll.
Well, I'm also very good at statistics. You can get rich people to say anything they want to. What they want to is they want to have a big heart, but they want to stop this problem. And they know that they have to delve into the numbers and do this right.
Right, but you can do it both, Congressman. You can stop it going forward. You can change the laws and change the enforcement model, make the border more secure and have more enforcement and vetting. Fine. But you also have incidental victims of people like Garcia. You don't make our country any more safe by getting rid of Jorge Garcia.
No, but Jorge Garcia may be one of those people that is on the good side. You've got a number of people that are on the bad side.
Yeah, so but most of them are on the good side. You know the statistics don't support this fear of immigrants.
Coming out of the report coming out of the Department of Justice shows exactly what we've seen is a plethora of people coming in through these chain migrations and family units.
But doesn't make them that they do criminal acts once they get here. The crime rate among the illegal immigrants, as you call them, is lower than you have for the rest of the citizens.
That's not what we're seeing out of the statistics out of Arizona. Being an illegal into this country is 2 times more prevalent in regards to butting up against the law.
Well, you're probably counting the entry and saying they broke the law de facto by how they came in.
These are violent crimes. These are also...
I welcome you to show me any statistics that show
that people who are undocumented have higher homicide rates
than people who are citizens. Please send it on. I'd appreciate it. Yeah. Let me get you on the shutdown while I have you here, sir.
Sure.
Do you believe that you can find accommodation within your own party to do a straight party line vote and get the CR passed?
I think we can. From this standpoint, I think there's something out there that can be achieved. But I find it very interesting that we've got Democrats that are holding hostage of a budget that's really unrelated and should be decoupled with DACA. I think there's a deal to be made there, and I think it's time that we break the camel's back in regards to coupling issues that are not related to the budget and our military's prowess and readiness and men and women in harm's way.
So keep DACA separate, and you're willing to work on a deal on DACA, but you don't want it as part of the CR. Fair point?
Absolutely. I can't vote for any of that if it's tied together. And Chris, I've been very consistent. I've asked for germaneness and, keeping single issues, from the day I came into Congress, having that debate about single issues and not clouding the issues with pork and stuff that are slid into these omnibus bills.
But you do want long-term military spending included in it.
Oh, absolutely.
Because, some members of your party don't like that either. I mean, some of them were for the sequester. They were for the hard cuts that were made on the military.
Do you think
you can get on the same page with that?
I do. But, trust is a series of promises kept. We've got to start looking at, when you see reports coming out and where it's 20 cents out of every dollar in the military is wasted, we ought to turn back in there. I want a strong military, but I want my resolutions and changes made. We offered amendments, a fair wage for a fair job that's fair to the taxpayers. And that's just making sure that people and contractors are paid fairly, open and paid fairly. That could have been another $11 billion in savings right there. Mm-hmm. So it's not the chance that we're not trying to put things forward. I want a strong military, but I also want reforms. That's what the American people demanded.
And the budget side is this Friday. You're saying you want to keep that clean, but you are also pledging that you will deal with DACA ASAP because you do care about these families that are caught in the lurch.
I care about all of immigration. Once again, go back to Ronald Reagan. I'm tired of blaming the government when people break the law. We got to go back to look at this because immigration is such a fabric of this country, but we want to do it right. There's a difference between illegal and legal immigration, Chris.
Right, but there's a difference among those who are undocumented, their circumstances, and their importance to this country.
But once again, you also have to look at it as a Trojan horse. If you don't get it right, you forever break up immigration from the controls that we're given.
And that assumes that immigration is a plague, right? Because that's what the Trojan horse was. It was filled with people who wanted to kill and destroy the people where it landed, right?
Well,
that's not what immigrants are. They're not looking to kill us.
Omar Mateen, Chris?
Look, you can cherry pick cases. There's no question that you have felons and drug addicts and terrorists. But if those are the people you want to get rid of, you should start with the civilian population first because the percentages are much higher. That's what I'm saying.
The thing about it is you understand precedent. So when you allow people to come in a precedent that establishes a pathway, it will be taken advantage of by the liberal courts. So, from that standpoint, that's how I look at it.
And I appreciate your take. You're always welcome on the show to discuss what matters to the American people.